Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Asmano from veenaasmano.com and I teach you how to cook, bake and decorate with confidence. So today I wanted to make a recipe with you for baked chicken legs. This is chicken drumsticks. And chicken drumsticks is basically the easiest dinner you can make quick in less than an hour. Every time you use a different marinade for this, it's going to be a completely different chicken. Absolutely. So today I'm going to show you with a basic marinade, but for this marinade, instead of using what I'm using today, you can use chicken seasoning, you can use curry powder, you can use Cajun spice. So any marinade you want, you can use on this. Two rules. You want to make sure that your marinade is in powder form so that you do not have too much of moisture. Otherwise, your chicken is going to stew. Okay. The other important thing you want to do is when you're baking it the way we are doing today is you want to keep the skin on because that skin is going to protect the chicken from drying out. So unless you're going to coat it with breadcrumbs, you don't want to remove the skin. Okay. So we're going to keep the chicken. Right. The other thing you want to do is to make sure that the chicken is dry. It's very important that you kind of really remove all that moisture because moisture is not going to let the chicken bake. It's going to stew and that's not what we want. The whole idea is to get a nice chicken that is kind of roasted almost, you know, kind of roasted inside the oven. Not so I took each and every chicken. The other thing you can do if you plan early is to actually thaw the chicken ahead of time and then keep it in the fridge overnight open. Just leave it on the baking tray open overnight. And that is going to make sure that the chicken is nicely. Now, if you have any hair or anything, make sure you get them out. They will cook off, of course. But again, we don't want to eat those. So my marinade for today is garlic powder, onion granules. You can use garlic powder, some salt, pepper. I've got some smoked paprika and a little bit of cumin, okay? That's all I'm going to use today. It's a very simple, very basic. I think almost everybody has it at home. You can also add dried thyme, dried rosemary, some oregano. All these are great additions, but I'm going to keep it really simple today because it's absolutely delicious just this way. Now, for the chicken, like I said, I've already dried everything out. I'm going to make sure that I put some oil. You don't want to swim the chicken in oil, but you do want oil because you want all the marinade to stick nicely. Now you can put this in a Ziploc bag and of course throw everything in, but I'm trying not to use plastic, so I usually do mine in a bowl, but again the choice is yours. Okay, there you go. You see this one? That's all done. You don't need too much. Next, we're going to take this and sprinkle it all around. Okay, sprinkle it all around. Gonna toss this up. Okay, we can also turn it around, of course. And there you go. Okay. And there you go. You see, all my marinades. Now, here's the thing. You can make this ahead of time and keep it in the fridge for up to 12 hours. So if you have a busy day coming up, you can make this ahead of time and keep it in the fridge. So to bake this, I've got a baking tray, which I have lined with foil. The foil is for easy cleanup, but it also prevents anything from sticking. Now, there are two ways to bake this. One is you can use a baking tray and foil like I am. The other thing is you can use a ceramic dish. Now, if you use a ceramic dish and put it, the chicken will stew. So it's a very completely different dish, but it's also very delicious. And I've made chicken thighs not long ago that way. And if you see that recipe, it's absolutely delicious. It's got those juices inside. It's pour it over the mashed potato. It's very delicious. So I'm just going to line this chicken right here. You can see, okay. I'm going to line it as best as I can. I like to do one this way and one the other way. So that way, let's do this like this, this, and Now you don't want to crowd your chicken in the pan because obviously you want to make sure that the air circulates nicely and it doesn't kind of get old. Okay. Now, if you have any marinade, don't let it go to the pan. Okay, so now this is going to go into my oven, which is already preheating, and I'm going to bake it for about 40-45 minutes, and then I'm going to show you how it, okay? So I'm going to remove the chicken out now because it's been about 40 minutes and I want to see it. Oh, look at that. See how beautiful that is? So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take some of this oil and kind of add a little bit of the oil to the marinade just to give it a little bit of shine. Okay. And that's it. This is our chicken all ready to be served. I'm just going to take a few pieces of to sprinkle it on top just because it looks pretty. I'm going to transfer these just about here to my platter so I can put them along my rice. Now, if you are serving these with guests around, and you know, sometimes it's what I like to do is actually put a piece of foil at the edge of the chicken leg, the drumstick, so people can just hold it and eat it. My kids like to do that, so that's what I usually do. Kind of like this. Take a piece of foil and put it right around this. And you kind of have a little drumstick to eat. The kids love to eat it like that. These juices in the pan are absolutely delicious, so do not throw them. Serve them with the rice, okay? I'm going to pour this on top of the chicken because that's how we like it. Okay, now you don't have to do this. You can keep it dry, but I absolutely love the marinade. And so there is nothing stopping me from putting this on top of my rice. Well, I hope you enjoyed this recipe. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And of course, subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos for me. And I'll see you on another video. Bye-bye for now.